The first three chapters of Paul's letter to the Ephesians are filled with eloquent and lengthy greetings, prayers, and thoughts about who we are and the inheritance we have in Christ. The remaining three chapters shift their focus as chapter 4 begins with the statement, "As a prisoner for the Lord, then I urge you to live a life worthy of the calling you have received." As the gears change in Ephesians, we read lists of do's and don'ts, be this and not that, put on this and take off that. Consequently, some perceive this opening statement in chapter 4 like a great or even impossible weight to carry. Many of us prefer the encouraging beauty of the first half of Ephesians, while we struggle more to appreciate the practical life guidance of the second half of the letter. In a similar way, and often following our example, the world around us responds to the call of the Christian life like a heavy burden, finding it difficult, if not impossible, to live up to the standards. They are often abandoned or traded in for easier or better fitting ideals, or perhaps none at all. As followers of Jesus, it is true. He isn't leading us down the easy path, and there is a cross we're called to carry daily. But rather than stringent rules of religion, Paul was communicating a beautiful way of life that is lived authentically in the love of God and power of His grace and Spirit. When we live in this way, the light of Christ is able to shine in and through us to reveal something that is both amazingly beautiful and powerfully transformative. Fortunately, God doesn't give half of Himself, doesn't love us with half a heart, and He doesn't leave us half finished. He's given all, doesn't withhold any of His love or grace from us, and calls us to live a full life in Christ. Join us at College Hill on Sunday mornings during the month of August as we explore together how to live a life worthy of the calling you have received.